Here are two key questions that will help you to decide whether you will need to run an experiment at all. Question number one, do I have a large enough audience to run this experiment? And it's a really important initial question to ask. We will define large enough more precisely in the statistics module, but for now, let's just discuss the importance of this. If you don't have a large enough audience, if your sample size is too small, you won't ever have enough data points to get statistically significant results, or in other words, to be certain that your results are real. Sometimes smaller marketing agencies come to my live workshops and they ask what they should A/B test on their own websites. And don't get me wrong, these marketing agencies are good businesses with 30, 40, sometimes even 100 clients. They are very, very profitable. But their website's traffic is usually not more than a few thousand visitors a month. And more importantly, they get on average only 1 to 5 new clients a month. In other words, they have 1 to 5 conversions a month. With those numbers, even if they A/B tested anything, they would have to wait years to collect enough data points to conclude their test. So what should these smaller marketing agencies A/B test then? Well, mostly nothing. They should not A/B test anything because A/B testing simply won't contribute to their business. In my experience, this is quite often true for most smaller B2B businesses. But just in general, if your traffic is low, A/B testing is not a good idea, however exciting it sounds. The second question you should ask, is A/B testing really the best solution to my given business problem? This question is about ROI, return on investment. Because A/B testing is an investment of work hours, so time and money. For that, you should expect some sort of return on this investment. Also remember that A/B testing is not conversion rate optimization, it's research. So the most important thing you will get out of an experiment is information and knowledge. Before you start your test, ask yourself this. To solve your given business problem, do you really need to run an A/B test? Will you use either short-term or long-term the information that you gather from an experiment? The answer is not always clear. Do you remember the story from the previous module where the company featured a video from an article on their homepage and as a result their overall conversion rate dropped 18%? That's a great example of a situation where they would have needed that information. They should have run an A/B test. And for them, A/B testing indeed would have been the best solution for that given business problem. But being brutally honest about it, that's not the case all the time. Quite often, changing a thing on your website is practically risk-free, so it's faster and more efficient to simply change it without testing it. Of course, this is a complex question, so I will dig deeper into it in the next videos in this module. But to make this clear, let me give you two specific situations when A/B testing is a really bad idea. The first situation is when you have a small audience. This is a ballpark figure only, but when you have less than 5,000 monthly visitors on your website, less than 5,000 subscribers on your newsletter list, or less than 5,000 impressions on your ads, it's not a good idea to run A/B tests. Why? Well, first of all, most probably, you simply won't have enough data points to get statistically significant test results, and this should be a good enough reason in itself. But there is one more aspect here. When you have a small business, the best return on investment usually doesn't come from optimizing the conversion rates. Let's run the numbers. I will show you an example and I will go with the market benchmarks in it. If you have 5,000 visitors per month, your conversion rate is 1% and you charge $100 for your product, then you make $5,000 per month, right? If you spend a fair amount of time with your A/B testing program and with conversion rate optimization, you will get an average 20, 30, or if you are very successful and lucky, then even 40% conversion increase in 3 months. But in my experience, at this size, if you spend your time purely on marketing and bringing in new visitors to your website instead of A/B testing, you can easily double or triple your audience size. And with that, usually you can close to double or triple your revenue too. It's 40% against 200%. That's a huge difference. Of course, in every business, there comes a point where your audience will start to grow more slowly, or when your team is so big that you can invest in conversion optimization and marketing at the same time, But if you are not there yet, maybe for now, running A/B tests is not the best option for you. A quick comment here. Notice how I said usually, most probably, or ballpark figure. This 5,000 number is not set in stone, but the point is you should be realistic about how do you invest your work hours. So run the numbers and figure out whether your business is ready to run experiments or not. And the second example when running an A/B test is a really bad idea is when you already know what the result of the test is. This sounds obvious, but I see this all the time. People get excited about running experiments, which is awesome, and so they want to test everything. It's less awesome. One last time, let me repeat this. A/B testing is an investment. You spend time and money on it. Be conscious about that time and money. If you know that your sales copy is terrible and converts close to 0%, then go ahead and pay for a professional copywriter to help you and feel free to replace the old version without A/B testing it. If you have low quality, sketchy product images or even worse stock photos on your website, and because of that your conversion rate is close to zero, pay a professional photographer and replace your old images without A/B testing them. Simple and fast, no need to complicate it with running unnecessary experiments. Okay, I hope this helps you to see more clearly. Simply answer these two key questions when you need to decide whether you will need to run an experiment or not. Do I have a large enough audience to run experiments? Is A/B testing really the best solution to my given business problem? And if the answer is no to either or both of these, then simply just do not run experiments.